Did you know that your smartphone needs more than 50 different raw materials to operate? Lithium, cobalt, and nickel power the battery. The chips need gallium and silicon metals. And without indium, touchscreens wouldn't work. If you feel like you've just been transported back to high school chemistry, it's because all raw materials are made from elements found on the periodic table. They are used in electric vehicles, renewables, digital technologies, the list goes on. While many elements are abundant in the Earth's crust, concentration levels of raw materials are very low. This makes it challenging to extract them in an environmentally friendly, sociably responsible, and economically viable way. Some of these raw materials are now dubbed critical in the EU because they are crucial to Europe's economy and there is a high risk associated with their supply. The EU started a critical raw materials list in 2014, and by the 2020 edition, its contents had more than doubled to 30 critical raw materials. For batteries, fuel cells, and energy storage, crucial to the EU's digital and green transitions, we only mine a tiny fraction of what we consume. For instance, we import 78% of lithium from Chile. We will need up to 18 times more lithium by 2030 and almost 60 times more in 2050 compared to today. When it comes to rare earth elements, a group of 17 elements, of which your smartphone needs 16, China provides an overwhelming 98% of the EU's supply. And even if we mine the materials ourselves, they have to be sent outside the EU to be processed. Earth observation data and geological surveys show potential for rare earth element mining in Europe, for example, in Sweden, Finland, or Germany. However, our budget for exploration is low compared to other regions in the world. And even with new reserves, we will still need to ramp up the EU's capacity when it comes to refining and alloying. For now, as current demand continues to soar, the EU will have to continue relying on international supply chains to fulfill its needs. This means that measures to make global trade markets more transparent, effective, and predictable are crucial. We will also need to promote a more circular use of critical raw materials by recovering more of these precious elements and repairing our old devices. Because without available, affordable, and responsibly sourced and processed raw materials, our ambition to be the first climate-neutral continent is at risk.